If you're processing Micro Four Thirds RAW files in Lightroom, don't touch this slider without watching this video first. This is one of several common mistakes that can ruin the quality of Micro Four Thirds RAW images. In this video, I'm going to show you what these are and explain to you how to avoid them using the shots from my previous video. If you're wondering about shooting landscape photography with Micro Four Thirds cameras, be sure to watch that one. You'll find a link to it in the YouTube video information. A common mistake made by people switching from a larger format to Micro Four Thirds is that they expose for the highlights in a scene. Then, in post-processing, they open shadows to reveal hidden detail. This is completely the opposite of what you should do using Micro Four Thirds, as you'll see with this image. It's a bracketed sequence of handheld shots, and I've selected an underexposed and an overexposed frame. Starting with the underexposed image, I'll increase the exposure and open the deep shadows. The first thing to notice is that it creates a horrible colour cast in the shadows. Now let's zoom into the shadow areas in the corner of the frame. Look at all the noise and poor detail where I've tried to recover the shadows. Now compare this to the overexposed image. First, there isn't any colour shift in the shadows and I don't need to recover them. Zooming into the corner of the frame at 200% magnification, there's much less noise and far better detail. The difference in image quality is like night and day. But the problem with this image is that it's overexposed and has blown out highlights. But watch what happens when I use the exposure and highlight sliders. I can fix the problems and the image looks great. If you want to achieve the best quality processing from your Micro Four Thirds RAW files, remember to expose for the shadows and not the highlights. Now for another example that also has a noise problem. If I zoom into the sky at 200% magnification, the blue areas of the image look terrible. This is happening even with the default sharpening and noise reductions in Lightroom. And if I turn off the color noise reduction, it makes the problem even worse. This happened even though I was shooting in bright daylight, and it's probably one of the reasons why people criticize Micro Four Thirds cameras. But the problem isn't the camera, it's the processing. Look at the detail panel in Lightroom. This is applying a default level of sharpening to the entire image, and it's exaggerating the noise in the sky. In a moment, I'm going to show you how to avoid this, but first let's exaggerate the noise to make it easier to see by increasing the sharpening. Now, one solution to prevent the noise becoming exaggerated is the masking slider, which is something a lot of photographers just ignore. This limits the sharpening in Lightroom to concentrate onto just edges and keeps it away from areas like the clear sky. If you hold down the Option or Alt key on your keyboard as you move the slider, you can see what's happening. Where the display is white, it means that the sharpening is being applied to those pixels in the image. As I move the masking slider to the right, you'll see areas of black develop which aren't being sharpened. What you need to try to do is balance the sharpening so that you don't exaggerate the noise in the sky, but you still sharpen the image. The problem is that you won't be able to remove all sharpening from the sky using only the masking slider. That requires a different approach, which I'll share with you in a moment. But something else that I can try first is applying a small amount of luminance noise reduction to smooth out the sky. I don't want to apply too much because it can ruin the detail in the ground and make it appear too smooth. Now that I've added some noise reduction, let me show you how to apply selective sharpening and noise reduction. This is what you should be doing when you process a Micro Four Thirds RAW file. I'll start by selecting the sky using the new masking tools in Lightroom. Now I can reduce the sharpening slider to minus 50. This is the magic number that removes all the sharpening we've applied in the detail panel. If you use a lower number than minus 50, you'll start to blur the image, so try to avoid this. Notice how the sky appears much smoother when I make this change. The other thing to try with the sky selection is to increase the noise reduction. The noise reduction slider here works in conjunction with the noise reduction sliders in the detail panel. This cleans up the sky nicely, and we can even go back to our detail panel to increase the sharpening there applied to enhance the landscape detail. This allows us to create a sharper detail in the landscape but without exaggerating the sky. So don't be lazy and make sure you apply sharpening and noise reduction selectively. And remember, we've been looking at the image magnified at 200% whilst applying these changes. If I zoom out to 100% magnification, you can now see the difference this makes to the image quality. Having refined the sharpening and noise reduction, it means I can apply another special slider that I like to use with landscape images. It's the dehaze slider. When you apply a dehaze adjustment, it changes the contrast in lighter areas of the image and it can make the sky pop. But there is a problem with the dehaze slider that's often overlooked, which is it exaggerates noise. In this image, it's not causing a problem though, because of the changes I made to the sharpening and noise reduction. But see what happens when I turn off the adjustments I applied to the sky. Noise becomes exaggerated all over the sky. But there's something else to consider when you're processing Micro Four Thirds RAW files. Whilst Lightroom makes a reasonable job of the RAW processing, it's not as good as some other RAW converters like Capture One and DxO Photo Lab. A good solution is to pre-process your RAW files using software like DxO Pure RAW. This produces a DNG file using deep prime noise reduction and optical corrections. When you then process your DNG file with Lightroom, you can achieve a much better result. Look at the difference pre-processing has made to this image. Even increasing the dehaze slider, you don't see noise in the sky. Whilst I've done this using DxO Pure RAW, you can achieve the same results with more control using DxO Photo Lab. In fact, you can even integrate DxO Photo Lab RAW processing with Lightroom, as I explain in this video. If you want to achieve the best image quality in Lightroom, you should watch that next.